rounds, ten rounds, nine rounds. I was fresh, like I've been on. Yeah, I was doing a bit of both. I think it dictated the pace of the job. The job was felt like it was landing a lot, short jobs, long jobs. I think the distance control was very, very good. And again, I was trying things out. Just happy with the performance. Lucas is a tough guy, you know, and he stayed in there. And I think if the corner hadn't missed really called him, he'd still have been there right at the end. So.
And the credit to the Bill.
Yeah.
That was a really good call from him.
And you could see actually before he could have thought around, I think he kind of called us out a bit, but he's kind of telling that.
Yeah.
Just one good point.
It's good preparation for him. We wanted to play.
Yeah, of course. Look, I know it's going to be a different story. Josh Warrington is a different task altogether. I think that he's riding on the crest of a wave at the minute. You know, he had the biggest win of his career against Selby. It's a good fight. It's not an easy fight, but I believe it's a big fight. And it's a big fight, especially in the UK and Ireland. But
it's a huge fight, you know. Yeah. And tonight, you've got two huge fights. You know, Carl and Josh Warrington is a dream fight. You know, that's a fight. Both have got great set, well supported, great sets of fans. It's going to be the atmosphere. You can imagine what the atmosphere is like. Going to be like, it'll be electric, but it will be a great fight. You know why? The styles, the will to win. They're both top of their game. It's not an old guy fighting a young guy. Mm. They're both, you know, in their prime. You're going to see something special. You know, that is going to be the best domestic fight for many, many years. I'm absolutely confident of that.
When do you think would be a sort of a date on a venue?
Before the end of the year. We've got to work it out because obviously another fight, and it's working out what dates these fights will take place.
Does Manchester make more sense because they say they're in?
Well, the problem you've got, I mean, we're in August, unfortunately, some have deserted us tonight, and it got quite wet, so it's not wet. And it's a stadium fight, but we're not going to get it into a stadium before Christmas, and the guys will wind up having in position where they'll be having mandatory defences, so we don't want to get bogged down with that, we want to get the fight on. And they both want it. You know, this is what it's about. This is the best fight and the best. And it's, you know, the fans are going to love this. They're going to benefit from it.
Colin, obviously you've dreamt of fighting here. You knew you couldn't fail, but was one of the most pleasing things for you tonight, and most people are seeing it as almost perfect performance, your composure was there in a major way. Was it composure that you really felt tonight?
Yeah, I felt very composed and disciplined, and if you look at the Denaro fight, I would probably say the same. I think a lot of that's down to the Jamie Moore, and he drills it into my head, breaking these guys down round by round and not trying to, you know, not getting too carried away with the occasion or the atmosphere. You know, cool head in a hot kitchen, that's the advice he gave me just before the first bell went, and I think it worked the truth. You know, I was breaking him down, done the job well, jab was good, distance control was good, and I got rid of him then when it came through.
And what was that feeling like walking outside? Because it was an amazing atmosphere.
It was unbelievable, honestly. I was, you know, if this is a bit vain, but I was watching myself on the big screen walking, and I was smiling at myself. Wow. And looked like I had a nice tan and stuff, and felt good, you know. Had the colour up and everything, it was good.
Carl, the fact that you were able to try things out, was that unusual for you in such a big fight? You've been so relaxed that you could do that?
Yeah, I think so. Don't want to give Luke the disservice, but I just feel like I was a step above, and I felt like I was able to read things and see things and judge. The distance was the main thing. I think that was everything. My distance control. Yeah, and the jab broke him down. Short jabs, long jabs.
You think you should have stopped him earlier if you had him maybe moved through the gears?
Maybe, but doesn't matter. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter. I don't know how to do, and the tall commander. He was a tough wee man, really, really hard man. I had him with a body shot before I dropped him. I took the body before I dropped him, and I don't know how he stayed up for me.
He done it a couple of rounds before. He hurt him, but you hurt him with it.
And he winced, but I felt it was one of them ones, you know, like good shot, feels good, and he stayed there. So hard wee man.
How excited
the fight is this Warrington fight? Very, very excited. I think my fans will be excited about it. I think Warrington's fans will be excited about it. I think the atmosphere is going to be electric. The it's going to be one of the best atmospheres ever. Talk about, and I don't want to blow my own trumpet or Warrington's trumpet. I don't want to blow Warrington's trumpet. it would be an unbelievable. I think it would be the best atmosphere in board boxing. Look at his fan, look at my fan. It would be amazing.
You know, it's funny that the four best supporting fighters, friends, Anthony Joshua, Carl, Josh, and Tyson. They're the four best supporting fighters. And you've got two of them fighting each other. So, you know it's going to be a cauldron.
You might have said it wrong, but frankly, he could easily have gone and done it wrong.
I think it says a lot about both. They've asked for it. It says a lot about the guys. I think it said a bit about us, because we could have carried on one fight here, one fight there. No, come on, let's do it. Let's give the guys what they want.
You said the other day this could be your last fight in Belfast, that you won't come back and do that again if it's possible.
Yeah, you never know what's going to happen. And the Odyssey now, you do something like that at Windsor Park, the Odyssey's almost probably too small to come back to. So I think it'd be the right time of the year. It needs to be the summer months. So you never know. Take one fight at a time. I'd like to fight one. This is the most active I've ever been in my career. I'm talking about you go right back to the start, 2009 when I turned pro. I think I'm fighting in 12 round fights and I'm more active now than I was then. This is what I want to be. I'm a professional.
You know it makes sense.
Of course. Yes. I want to fight. I'm a boxer. A professional boxer and I want to fight. And I want to do it. I want to keep going. I want these big fights. But to come back to Belfast, it would need to be next summer. You could come back to Belfast in February or whatever. So you never know. But
back
here. I want to come back here. I love it. Love that. Love that.
Could we see this being a rematch, a possible trilogy? There's a potential for the fight.
Depends how the fight turns out. I mean, you know, everybody has an opinion on fights. Everybody has an opinion on this fight. And who knows what's going to happen? All I know is going to be competitive.
Yeah.
And that's the name of the game.
You wouldn't rule out Frank coming back in a year's time?
Yeah, of course. I love it. I mean, we had the best time, don't we? Drink, we go to nice restaurants, and we enjoy what we're doing. And more importantly, we come in and we put fights on in venues where the fans are so knowledgeable and so appreciative. That's the thing about it. I mean, they're so knowledgeable. They get behind it. When you think the size of the city, the population, you think like the ratio, how many people come to the fights. It's I can't think of many places like it.
I looked out tonight. Stevie Ward was fighting at whatever time, 7 o'clock, and the crowd was, you don't get that anywhere else, they're not in to watch.
They just come in at the main event, they come early and then...
Brilliant boxing fans in Belfast.
Currently, you said in the sort of build-up to this fight that you feel in your prime, is that tonight, cement in your mind that you're...
Yeah, I knew it, I knew already, but it's about proving to other people, not that I need to prove to other people, but now they know, I was relaxed there, I was very, very relaxed tonight.
Jimmy? Have you missed that performance as the best Carlos produced, or was Dunair better?
It's difficult to assess whether he's better than Dunair, but I think he's better. I think he's got better performance as well, which is a scary thought,
isn't it?
Yeah, of course it is, but he's shown improvements tonight in certain aspects, adding to his style, which is, you know, at 31, you don't want to change too much, but there's always room for improvement, and he's getting better, which is a scary thought, you know. I think you'll see the better performances will come against the better opposition because, you know, even though that was a massive occasion tonight, Luke Jackson wasn't a danger man in that sense, even though he was a very good, solid fighter. So I think, you know, Carl fighting on adrenaline when he knows he's up against it, he will be a different animal.
Would you say this approach, the level of your first fight with Santa Cruz?
Say it again, sorry.
Was this on the level for you, your performance as the first fight with Santa Cruz?
Yeah. Again, it's hard to say. It was a different performance, Santa Cruz. Again, I don't want to sound disrespectful to Luke Jackson, but Santa Cruz is a much different fighter than Luke. That was a big win for me. But this occasion was bigger, even than Santa Cruz, Windsor Park, you know what I mean? And it's something I've thought about for a long time. So there could be no slip-ups. And Luke was entitled to perform out of his skin there tonight, you know, there was no pressure on him there at all, but And other guys would have fell over and folded, but he was still there. I could see him wincing. You know, I was hurting him. I knew I was hurting him. And he had a little wince, and he'd come straight back. He was a tough boy.
You said you were nervous, Carl, before. Did those nerves, where did the nerves go?
I was nervous. It was weird. I was nervous when I was eating dinner tonight. I'm not usually nervous that far out, but in the change room, there was cameras and stuff in the change room. You may have seen it. It was relaxed. The boys were singing and messing about and telling jokes, and that's the atmosphere that I like. So in the change room, the nerves were gone, and when I was standing on the ramp, I was just ready to do the job.
Oh, you'd be disappointed for Paddy, obviously, in his fight.
Yeah, I'm gutted for him. You know, I really believe he's going to win, and I'm hearing, I'm getting reports back after each round, and everyone's saying he's winning the fight. Well, he's doing well, and I haven't seen it yet, but it sounded like he had crunched with an almighty body shot. And he said, I went to see him, and he says it was a crippling body shot, and that was it. And Paddy dared to be, you know what I mean? He went and he fought for a world title in a sick fight against a very good fighter, and he can come back again. I know he'd be disappointed, and I'm disappointed for him, but Paddy Barnes can come back and win a world. It was only six fights in. He's still a lot more to give, and he was winning the fight up until that happened. Body shots.
The fellas on the undercard had more fights than him. Mm. And when you look at it, and they were you know, 9 rounds and 6 rounds.
Is he okay with some of it? I got stretched out at one point.
I've heard that he's okay. I don't want to talk about it.
He came back to ringside.
Jimmy, what specifically did you feel he added to his game tonight? What were the things that you
really body snatching? I think, you know, I've said it loads of times ever since we started working together. I don't want to change him. He's a phenomenal fighter anyway, but I wanted to add to it. And one of the things what I felt like he could improve on was body punching. I think I'm a big believer in it. I think he's a vital part of anyone's makeup, especially when, you know, yeah, top world level. That can be the big difference between, you know, winning a close decision or losing one. So he's, think when you're adding to someone's style, it takes time to sink in and gel, and for it to become second nature. And it just started to click tonight. You could see, especially in this camp during the last 12 weeks, you could see he was hurting people sparring with body shots, I firmly believe that the reason he got Jackson out of there tonight was the body work, because you could have hit him in the head all night long and he wouldn't have gone anywhere. So that's the reason they got the stoppage tonight, I believe.
It's been nearly a year that you and Carl have been together now, Jeremy. I'm pleased that we've managed to achieve this past 12 months.
Yeah, obviously I'm over the moon. It's come out of the blue, and you know, I still don't really class myself properly as a trainer, even though it sounds mad, but I just feel like I'm helping the lads achieve whatever they want to achieve. But honestly, the way I look at it. And, yeah, it's going great. You know, we've had a great 12 months with some big wins. Martin Murray, Jack Carroll.
He's a good trainer, don't worry.
Yeah, lucky for him. And I'm still only 20 years old.
What's the situation, Frank, with the WBA title in terms of Valdez?
We'll see what happens. He's supposed to, you know, I thought it was going on with him at the moment. I think no reason to stay that weight, so we'll see. We'll see, but you know, we can't wait around.
Well, presumably, Frank is saying that the fight between Carl and Josh is this year, would have to go indoors.
Yeah.
So it would be Manchester or London.
Yeah, it'd be a big, big.
Because it's a 20,000.
Yeah, whatever it is, it'd be sold out, and that's it.
What would you favour, Carl?
Doesn't matter, to be honest. I think Manchester or London probably has the biggest arenas they can be in, so either or. Doesn't really matter. Manchester's closer, to be honest. Easier access for
adopted McNamara.
It's only down the street, like where I train, so big Man City fan as well. Don't follow anyone in England, just to put it out there, but Manchester probably makes more sense.
And happy hunting ground for you.
Yeah, but I've already won a big fight there. A domestic fight. They're unhappy with her.
Can we just do a couple of questions? Because he's obviously late. Sure. He's
going to be the Scott Quigg fight was billed as going to be a thrilling fight, and although he performed really well, it wasn't a thriller. Would the Warrington fight be that kind of
You never know. I think it probably has the ingredients. The Scott Quigg tactics when he fought me were strange, to say the least. And I won the fight kind of not having to really do a lot. So I don't think Josh Warrington is going to give me six rounds by not doing anything. So completely different fight. I think it would be a better fight. Have to be, it couldn't be any worse.
Right, are we done?
Yeah.